Welcome back. My name is Mohd Abubakar Siddiq, Assistant Professor at Potuakhali Science and Technology University, Bangladesh. After this video, you will be able to explain the focus areas of land use planning, different level of land use planning, including national, district and local level, and the sustainability process of land use planning. So let's begin with the focus areas of land use planning. Planning for people is the first focus area of land use planning. The planning process is driven by the demands of the people of the planning area. Local farmers, other land users and the wider community who depend on the land must accept the need for a change in land use, as they will have to live with its results. The planning team must find out about the people's needs as well as the local knowledge, skills, labor and capital that they can contribute in planning process. It must study the problems of the existing land uses practices as well as explore the alternative options. Local acceptability is most readily achieved by local participation in the planning process. The concept land is not same everywhere is the second focus area of land use planning. Capital, labor, management skills and technology can be moved to everywhere they are needed. Land cannot be moved and different areas have different opportunities and different management problems. For example, each hazardous area needs specific management. Good information about land resources is therefore essential in land use planning. The third focus area of land use planning is technology. Knowledge of land use technologies such as agronomy, livestock husbandry, and other means by which land is used is necessary in land use planning. The technologies recommended must be those for which users have the capital, skills and other necessary resources that is appropriate technology. New technologies may have social and environmental implications that should be addressed by the planners. The fourth and final focus area of land use planning is the integration. A mistake in earlier terms at land use planning was to focus too narrowly on the use of land resources. Good agricultural land is usually also suitable for other competing uses. Land use decisions are not made just on the basis of land suitability, but also according to the demand for products and the extent to which the use of a particular area is critical for a particular purpose. Planning has to integrate information about the suitability of land and the demand for alternative products or uses and the opportunities for satisfying those demands on the available land now and in the near future. Land use planning at different level. Land use planning can be applied at three broad levels: national, district and local. These are not necessarily sequential but correspond to the level of the government at which decisions about land use are taken. Different kinds of decisions are taken at each level, where the methods of planning and the kinds of plan also differ. However, at each level, there is need for the land use strategies and policies that indicate planning priorities and need for projects that tackles these priorities. And finally, need for operational planning to get the work done. The greater the integration between the three levels of planning, which are national, district and local, will achieve the better outcome. The flow of information should be in both directions. National level planning. At national level, planning is concerned with national goals and the allocation of resources. In many cases, national land use planning does not involve the actual allocation of land for different uses, but the establishment of the priorities for district level projects. A national land use plan may cover land use policy. It includes balancing the competing demands for land among the different sectors of the economy, such as food production, export crops, tourism, wildlife conservation, housing and public amenities, roads, industries, etc. National Development Plan and Budget is emphasize the project identification and the allocation of resources for development. Coordination of sectoral agencies involved in land use. Legislation on such subject as land tenure, forest clearance and water rights. District level land use planning. and planning is initiated nationally, national priorities have to be transferred into local plan through district level land use planning. Conflicts between national and local interest will have to be resolved in this stage. The kinds of issues tackled at this stage include the meeting of development, such as new settlement, forest plantation, and irrigation schemes. The need for improved infrastructure, such as water supply, roads, and marketing facilities. The development of management guidelines for improved kinds of land use on each types of land. Land use planning at local level. The local level unit of planning may be the village, a group of villages, or a small water catchment. At this level, it is easiest to feed the plan to the people, making use of local people's knowledge and their contributions. While planning is initiated at the district level, the programs of work to implement change in land use or management has to be carried out locally. Alternative, this may be the first level of planning, and we consider it as the bottom-up planning. Bottom-up planning is initiated at local level and involves active participation by the local community. The experience and the local knowledge of the land users and local technical staff are mobilized to identify development priorities and to draw up and implement plans. There are several advantages of land use planning. It represents local targets, local management, and local benefits. In this process, people will be more excited about a plan seen as their own, and they will be more willing to participate in its implementation and monitoring. It will create more popular awareness of land use problems and opportunities. Local level plans can pay close attention to local constraints, whether these are related to natural resources or socio-economic problems. This way, better information is transferred upward for higher levels of planning. Major disadvantages of bottom-up planning. Local interests are not always seen as regional or national interest. Difficulties occur in integrating local plans within a wider framework. Limited technical knowledge at the local level means technical agencies need to make a big investment. Local efforts may collapse because of a lack of higher-level support. Sustainability of land use planning. Land use is considered to be sustainable when it is both socially and environmentally compatible, technically viable, and when it makes economic sense. This includes social justice, which emphasizes on the participation of all clusters people for spreading and distributing social benefit to the all groups, including socially weak parties. Long-term sustainability of natural resources. The land utilization type must be designed to ensure that the natural basis of living is sustained for future generations. Therefore, we need to consider naturally potential of land resources. Hence, existing environmental damage should be minimized and damaging developments avoided by supporting and developing suitable approaches. Acceptance and social compatibility. The measures applied are to be desired, accepted, and supported, and largely carried out by those affected by them. The effects of such measures can only be sustainable if they are socially compatible and culturally suitable. And this will be achieved when we consider the local knowledge and capacities. Economic efficiencies. The measures planned should be designed to contribute to the long-term security of the economic basis for the people's livelihood. Therefore, the measures should be self-financing and thereby economically justified. In this way, community will contribute to the improvement of the living conditions and to the overall economic development. Viability. The plan measure should be sound with the level of tolerance of the local population in terms of technology, economy, and organization. Decisions are generally guided by the local technological understanding and culture, as well as the availability of the resources. So, in this way, land use planning will be sustainable for the future generation. Thank you for watching this video. We will discuss about the steps of land use planning in the next video.